Listen in to this exclusive interview done by my colleague Rohini Swami.
Almost all our well-wishers and workers are telling don't continue in this party. There is a general opinion in the entire state. I am thinking twice because I don't want to harm this government. That's why I am waiting for up to December. Most probably I will not continue this party because our central leadership are pulling me down. They are under that impression. Unfortunately, whoever is trying to pull me down are not realizing that they are pulling down the Bharatiya Janata Party. Yediyurappa is Bharatiya Janata Party. Bharatiya Janata Party is Yediyurappa. Anant Kumar Advaniji wants that Anant Kumar should become the Chief Minister of Karnataka. If it is so, they could have told openly, Yediyurappa ji, you please step down. We want to make him the Chief Minister. Why they are doing like this? When in all respect, our state government is number two in progressive state in the entire country. When I was the Chief Minister, unnecessarily they asked me to step down because of this Lokayukta report, Santosh Hegde's report. And Santosh Hegde himself told openly that plenty of times, I have not asked Yediyurappa to step down as Chief Minister. Just I have given some report. On that basis, central government is our state leaders, central leaders taken some decision. For that, I am not responsible. That's what Santosh Hegde told. I want to know from the central leadership, why you asked me to step down from that for the Chief Minister's post? Why you have promised that immediately as soon as get some relief from the court, we are going to make you Chief Minister again? Why you have not kept up your promise? What is exactly in your mind? Reason is, Advani ji don't want Yediyurappa. He wants only Anant Kumar. That is why our Nitin Gadkari ji and Jaitley ji, even today they know that Yediyurappa is not done any mistake. Because of Advani ji, they are unnecessarily they are keeping quiet. So why should I give us a trouble to Nitin Gadkari ji or Jaitley ji? That's why I'm simply going around in the state taking the opinion of the people, and I'm going to take my own decision in the month of December. Even if they offer Chief Minister post or in the President post, the time is, I'm not going to accept any post in Bharatiya Janata Party. I will go to the people, and whatever people will take decision, I will abide with the people of decision of the Karnataka.
All right, Rohini Swami now joins us from Bangalore with the latest. Rohini, Yediyurappa there landing no soft punches on the BJP. It almost appears as if he's set to break away from the party and float his own political outfit as he talks about a regional outfit from Karnataka with the support of a lot of MLAs that he has in the state. But at the same time, it appears that he is actually extending that deadline, because earlier he was talking about gauging the mood of the people and in November deciding which way to go really, and now he's actually giving his party time till December. So should this be seen as an extension of deadline?
Well, not exactly, but we have seen how Mr. Yediyurappa has been dropping enough hints about going solo or floating his own party. This, the way he has come across in this interview, where he has bared his heart out, very clearly shows that he's giving time only till December, because, like he said in his own words in the interview, that he's the man who has made Jagdish Shetty the Chief Minister. He would not like to deceive him. He would not like to bring him down as of now. So in December, when he decides to go, he says all the MLAs who are in the government as of now, that is Jagdish Shetty's government, can come with him. He's looking at garnering as much support as possible. The fact that he's just come back from a tour of his constituency, he's saying that people over there, his party workers and his men, are saying that he should not remain in the Bharatiya Janata Party, rather go on his own. And that is what he's trying to say. The charisma of Yediyurappa can draw crowds, can draw votes for him. And even if he's in the party or if he goes away from the Bharatiya Janata Party, Yediyurappa will be able to use the same charisma to garner as much votes. But more importantly is the way he has hit out at Lal Krishna Advani, saying that he's the man who's causing this kind of distress, especially for Yediyurappa. The fact that Lal Krishna Advani does not like Yediyurappa, that he wants Anand Kumar to be instated as the Chief Minister. And right here, a very hurt Yediyurappa, who has been saying quite often that he will not accept any post now from the Bharatiya Janata Party, be it the state presidentship or the Chief Ministership. So obviously here, a very strong hint and a very clear indication that he is going to launch his party.
All right, so it appears that BSY is going to be on his own shortly. Let me also bring in our political editor, Javed Ansari, for more on this. Javed, the significance of Yediyurappa in BJP's scheme of things in Karnataka was known from the time that the party had shown reluctance to drop him, even as those charges of corruption surfaced against BS Yediyurappa. He seemed to be very cut up with L.K. Advani. He has named him several times in the interview, saying that it's Advani who actually doesn't want him to be the chief minister, doesn't want him there in Karnataka for the party. He prefers Anand Kumar over Yediyurappa. Are there no attempts that are being made from the central leadership of the BJP to actually intervene and ensure that BS Yediyurappa doesn't float his own political outfit, which in turn would hurt the BJP?
No, Ruchika, the BJP central leadership has been making efforts. Mr. Arun Jaitley is the points person. He has on several occasions prevailed upon Mr. Yediyurappa, dissuaded Yediyurappa from precipitating a crisis or from taking that all-important step of severing his links with the BJP. Mr. Arun Jaitley last week was in Bangalore with the idea of trying to, you know, work his magic once again on Mr. Yediyurappa. But he's been chafing at the bit. His patience appears to be running out, and he's given the strongest indication yet, not just of thinking in terms of severing his links, but also attacking the senior-most leader in the BJP. He's minced no words in coming out and openly attacking and accusing Mr. Advani of not just undermining him, but also trying to put in place, replace him with Mr. Anand Kumar, who Mr. Yediyurappa believes is a non-entity as far as the politics in Karnataka is concerned.
All right, so Yediyurappa there making his anguish known in that interview to Rohini Swami this morning. Thank you very much, Javed and Rohini, for joining us with your inputs.